organ donor can save 8 lives and change the lives of many more than 50 people. And according to transplants.org, 22 people die every day while waiting for a transplant. If you haven't caught on to what my topic is, today I'm going to be discussing you what organ donation is so important. We will be talking about what organ donation is, how it helps people, and why organ donation shortages are so common and what you can do to stop them. I want you right now to imagine yourself as your time comes saving the lives of our future. As adults, we want our family's future to be great. One way you can do this is becoming a donor and saving the future. So what exactly is organ donation? Well, Donate.life describes organ donation as a process of surgically removing one organ or tissue and placing it into another person's body. Organ transplantation is one of the great advances in modern medicine. This has allowed for great leaps in how people can recover from injuries or sickness. About every organ or tissue in your body can be transplanted with these. These organs are in the heart, intestine, kidneys, liver, lungs, pancreas, and the tissues are bone, cartilage, corneas, fascia, heart valves, ligaments, pericardium, skin, tendons, and veins. The nice thing about becoming a donor is that anyone can. Literally anyone can donate. And I mean anyone. And anyone can donate the organs I just listed off. No matter what age, race, or religion, you can donate and help save lives. Now that we have discussed what organ donation is, let's talk about how it helps people. So you might be saying, I don't know if this stuff is true, or is it actually real? Organ shortages like an actual thing? Well, yeah, they are, and it's a big problem in today's society. The unavailability of organs for transplantation is to meet the existing demand has produced into a major organ shortage crisis. With that said, I gave you some numbers above on the amount of people that get the organs they need and the amount of time and the amount that don't, but I want to give you another set of numbers. According to ncbi.org, in 2006, the waiting list has risen over 95,000, while the number of patient deaths while waiting is over 6,300. The success of any transplant program depends on the number of individuals who indicate in advance of their death and willingness to be donors. The willingness of people is a problem. It's a problem and it needs to be fixed. So how does organ donation help people that are in need? Well, it's easy. It saves their life. But it's how long those people have to wait is the problem. There are over 120,000 people in need of transplants right now, just in America. According to organdonor.gov, out of those 120,000, an average of 79 people receive a transplant, but an average of 22 people die each day. Also, there that are just on the waiting list and waiting for their name to be called. This is all happening while every 10 minutes a person gets added on the waiting list. So the number never stops. There are benefits of becoming a donor. For the transplant recipient, you are providing them with a second chance. For the donor or the families, you have the ability to save their lives and the ability to comfort a grieving family that's obviously in need. Now, those benefits, they're not money or they're not a brand new car, but those benefits I would take over money any day. Since you now know how and why becoming an organ donor is important, let's dive into why organ shortage is so common for us today. So today I talked to you about what organ donation is, how it helps people, and why organ donation shortages are common, and what you can do to stop them and help those families in need. Organ shortages is a major problem, and it is easy as signing your name at the DMV. So just imagine how many people you could save in being an organ donator and saving the lives of our future.